today we will discuss about the cultivation practices of sugarcane. Next, please. Sugarcane, the common name is known as sugarcane, botanical name is Saccharum officinarum. The family of the sugarcane is the Gramineae. It belongs to Brassicaceae family. Next, please. Importance. Sugarcane is have wide importance of its the sugarcane is the main source of sugar in India and holds a prominent position as a cash crop. So India was the second largest producer of sugarcane in the world after Brazil in 2014-15. Sugarcane is the renewable natural agricultural resources because it provides sugar beside biofuels, fiber, fertilizer and myriads of byproducts, co-products with ecological sustainability. Its juice is used for making white sugar, brown sugar known as khansari and jaggery known as gold. It is one of the main crop of earring for regional exchange. The main byproduct of sugarcane industry are baggies and molasses. Baggies and is mainly used as a fuel. And it is also used for production of compressed fiber board, paper, plastic and furfural. Molasses is used for distillation for the manufacturing of ethyl alcohol, butyl alcohol, citric acid, etc. Sugarcane press mud has good potential as organic fertilizer. Green cobs of cane are good source of fodder for the cattle. Then sugarcane is rich in antioxidant, so it helps fight infections and boost the immunity. It rich in the iron, magnesium, calcium and other electrolytes, so it's great for dehydration. It helps cure the common cold and other infections and also fight fever as it boosts the body body's protein level. Then climatic requirement. The sugarcane is best suited to the regions having tropical climate, but it can be grown successfully in the subtropical areas also. In Punjab, about 80% of the total crop of the crop take place during July, August and the September owing to favorable temperature and humidity. Soil type, sugarcane can be successfully grown on all type of soils ranging from sandy loamy to clay loam soil. However, it thrives best on well-drained loamy soil. Sugarcane is semi-tolerant to sodicity and the salinity. Then, varieties of the sugarcane, COPB 92, it was established in 2017. The juice contains 16-17% and it produces the average yield that is 335 quintal per acre. Then CO118, it was established in 2015 and produces the cane yield that is 320 quintal per acre. COJ85, it was established in 2000 and produces average cane yield is about 305 quintal per acre. COJ64, it was established in 1975, it's a very old variety and produces cane yield that is 300 quintal per acre. Then mid-late maturing varieties is COPB93, it was established in 2017 and produces average cane yield that is 390 quintal per acre. COPB94, it also was established in 2017 and produces the average grain yield that is 400 quintal per acre. Then CO238, it was established in 2015. COPB91, it was established in 2014. COJ88, it was established in 2002. Next, please. Then agronomic practices. The subsoiling, because the sugarcane are transplanted or are sowing of sugarcane are done through the canes, the cutting of the canes. So that's why we do this deep plowing in this sugarcane. The subsoiling we do, the cross subsoiling at 1 meter spacing should be done. Once once in 3 to 4 years before preparing the field. This is done by tractor drawn subsoiler up to a depth of 45 to 50 cm. Do planking to break the clods and previous seed beds. This will help in breaking the hard pan, increase water infiltration and better penetration of the root. Then land preparation for give 3 to 4 plowings, each followed by planking. Use a furrow planting plow for the first plowing. Then time of planting, mid-February to the end of March is the optimum time for planting sugarcane in the Punjab. Do not plant early maturing variety after March. Then seed rate and seed treatment. Seed rate, I use 20,300 sets of or 15,400 sets or 12,500 sets per acre. Longer sets are particularly good for rated condition. In other words, 30 to 35 quintal of seed, depending upon the variety, is required for the sowing 1 acre area. Due to thick cane, seed rate of CO118 and CO85 should be kept about 10% higher than the normal sowing. Then seed treatment to improve the germination, soak the seed in ethyl solution overnight. To prepare the solution, dissolve 25 ml of ethyl, 39 SL in 100 liter of water. Alternatively, soak the sets in water for 24 hours before planting. Then fertilizer application. Next, please. Spacing and planting technique. Trench planting. Plant crop in rows 75 cm apart and 20 to 25 cm deep in trenches. Then in sugarcane cutter planter, in this case, we use 2-row tractor operated whole cane cutter planter. The complete sugarcane, which is fed by the labor setting on the machine, is cut automatically into pieces before dropping in the furrows. Fertilizer application. Organic and biofertilizer. Apply 8 tons of FYM press mud per acre 15 days before planting and mix into the soil with a plow or tiller. Then chemical fertilizer. 90 kg per acre nitrogen and 12 kg phosphorus per acre are required for the sugarcane planting. Then plant crop. Apply one half dose of nitrogen at top dress. Drill alongside the cane rows with first irrigation after germination. Top dress or drill the remaining half dose of nitrogen alongside the cane rows in May or June. Apply full dose of phosphorus based on soil test in furrows below the cane sets at the time of planting. Culture weed control. Cultural control, 2 or 3 burrowing can be done with a trifari or tractor mounted tiller or tractor operated rotary weeder. The spreading of trash blanket between the canes after the emergence of the shoots help in stress the weed growth because these act as the mulching. Then chemical control for pre-sowing emergence application of 800 gram per acre atrataf solero, mesataf, marcazine 50 WP, these are the byproducts of atrazine, or sanker 70 WP metribuzine are used in 200 liter of water. Then irrigation and drainage, hot and dry period during April to June is the most critical period for growth of sugarcane. During this period, irrigate the crop at 7 to 12 days interval. During the rainy season, adjust the frequency of irrigation according to rainfall. Drain away excess water from the field, the sugarcane field, if these gets flooded during the rainy season. During winter, November to January, irrigate the crop at monthly interval to save the crop from frost. Apply one irrigation around mid-December and another in the first week of January. So thank you. So if you have any query. like any question, you can ask me question. Okay, all the best.